I want to ask you, this issue's come up often, and I really do. First of all, I want to tell you that I appreciate your comments about standing up for the 250,000 New Jersey commuters who utilize the Port Authority bus terminal. And the question I have for you is, are we making progress? Because I brought it up this morning. I wish there was more of a discussion of having something done on the Jersey side, because we're not really addressing the issue of the congestion and everything else. But where do you stand? What is going to be done? And how are you now fighting for New Jersey?
Well, I think what has to be done is a new bus terminal needs to be built in Manhattan. The notion that some have about building a bus terminal on the New Jersey side and then having people switch and get on another means of transportation just isn't workable and isn't practical. But what I heard yesterday from Chairman Degden was concerning, because
why?
This plan they have to allocate less than half the money to start the bus terminal was based on an agreement with New York and New Jersey, and you know how this agency works is you get one, I get one.
Yeah.
Then at the last minute, New York State, through the governor's office and legislators and Congressman Nadler, have upped the pressure against this terminal by demanding a higher level of environmental review, which is just going to delay the construction of the bus terminal for up to 5 years. It's unconscionable.
So you don't think that their pushing for an environmental review is sincere? You think this is about politicking? It's not about the environment?
Well, part of the they're already doing an environmental review. That's going to take 18 months. They want to do a second tier, which is an analysis of all of the alternative transportation methodologies in the bi-state area. And the Port Authority's already done that study couple years back. So it's really asking the Port Authority to redo something they've already done.
At what point does the Port Authority get their head out of the sand and realize that all of these transportation projects really have to be planned together? Because we're going to find ourselves in 14, 15, 20 years with the same problems we have today, with commuters being stuck, with back log jams, etc. And my guess is, like many of these transportation projects, you're going to end up over budget as well as behind schedule.
Well, that's always a problem because you wind up studying it to death. All that costs
right.
money.
Right.
And then after you're done studying it to death, then you have to find the money to build it.
Yeah.
And we all know that the Port Authority has an appetite to plan more than they can afford. And so that's the other concern, because one of the things mentioned by Chairman Degden at the hearing yesterday was that we might have to find more money. And that concerns me because the tolls are already $15.
It's outrageous.
Look
at what it is for trucks. It's crazy what they're charging to get over the bridge.
What this is fast saying is that the Port Authority no longer serves a valid purpose. I mean, think about it. It was designed to take the politics out of transportation planning in the bi-state region, and now it's become nothing but a political football.
Yeah. Ask you real quick, give yourself some odds here. How difficult is it going to be to win a Democratic primary against a guy that's got almost unlimited funds to spend in this self-funded effort, Phil Murphy?
Well, I'll just say this real quickly, that money isn't everything in a race. And when you look at where we stand, recent FDU poll, Rutgers Eagleton poll, despite his spending a lot of money for the last 2 years, most people have no idea what's going on in this race, and it's wide open.
Yeah, millions of dollars to get 17%, tied with other